Everybody, welcome back to another video. I know I've made one for a week or so since my G-Fest live streams, but in today's video I will be showing off what my G-Fest haul was. I don't know what you really would want to call this, but I would say a good amount of things for my G-Fest haul. Pretty good, I would say. This is pretty much everything I have got since around May-ish. Sometime in the last 2 months or so. Last two-ish months, I would say. So, let's not waste any more time and get into it. So, first, I got a few movies, so, and I almost dropped them. I don't know if you heard that, but that would not have been good. So, the first one I got is a double feature of 1933 Kong and Son of Kong. I pretty much just got it for Son of Kong, and, might get rid of my just, version of King Kong 33, but I don't know, because I do like King Kong 33. It's one of my favorite films, so I might keep it, might not. If you want it, message me. The next one I got is King Kong Escapes. So pretty cool movie with Mecha Kong and Gorosaurus, not bad. And then the 1976 King Kong with Jeff Bridges, and you can see the big name actors on top there. So this is the 1976 King Kong. The next film is something I don't know how many people know or have heard of, but it is a film called Monsters. It was made by Gareth Edwards, the guy who made Godzilla 2014. I almost had a brain fart there. It was released through 2010, but yes, I watched this film a few months ago, and I really enjoyed it, so I got the DVD of it. Alright, we're almost done with the films. I got Rampage with Dwayne The Rock Johnson. This is based off of a 80s video game. I'm just taking a wild guess to say 80s, but I think it is. If I'm wrong, fact check me in the comments below. But it's with a giant white gorilla, this crocodile, and a rat and a wolf. They're like radioactive or something. I forget the exact reasoning of why, but pretty cool movie. Like it, not bad. So that is all of the films I got. I got, I don't even know, 6 DVDs. Well, 7, because one is a double feature, but 6 cases of DVDs. Alright, now let's get into the good stuff. The figures or toys. So, this is pretty much just things I've gotten the last few months, so. The first thing is the Playmates Destroyer. I don't know, I do have a Destroyer figure in my collection, but this is my second. To be honest, it's not bad, but it's not great either. It's Playmates. I'm not really expecting much out of them, but those new Kong figures, Godzilla vs. Kong figures, actually look pretty cool. So, yep, Playmates Destroyer. Got it for like $12 at Walmart or something. It wasn't too overly priced. The next thing I got is something I just kind of need in my collection, I guess. It is a Final Wars Anguirus. This is the 2019 Movie Monster Series Bandai reissue. It's alright. It's not the best Anguirus Final Wars figure, but it's okay. There we go. Anguirus. The next thing I got was the Blue NECA Mothra, the poster version, I think is the official name for this Mothra is. And actually, it's standard. They kind of repainted it a little. And the wings can actually kind of stay because I have the original normal version, but they kind of just like fall down. But these actually kind of stay up. I'm kind of wagging around, so they might fall down a little like that. But yep, a pretty cool figure. Got it off Amazon. The next thing I got was the Toho Kaiju series 2002 Godzilla. This is my, or 2002, 99 from Godzilla 2000. It's kind of confusing with the title, but the film was released in 99. Pretty cool. I like, all I had was the Bandai Creations, and that was kind of goofy, so I went with this guy, and I pretty much went off of it because I like the spikes the most, and got it for like 35 bucks off of Showcase Daikaiju, I believe. Another thing I got, I don't have it with me at the moment, but it's, I got the Godzilla Monopoly game. It's, I've already played it once, and it was, once. But it was a fun game, so it's Monopoly. It's fun, so, yep. Let me get the next figure. You probably already saw it quickly, but it is the, some vintage Bandai Showa Engear from the Destroyer Old Monsters. I think it's part of some 8-inch line, I believe, because it's kind of bigger. He's a big boy, so yep, Engear, and like everything with tag, and I also put the plastic sleeve on it. So the next thing was from Rich Iso, and didn't come with a tag, but this thing is really, really hard to find with a tag because how old it is, and of what it is, I didn't want to spend so much money on something that I don't really love, and it is a Showa Ghidorah. I was debating on getting a bootleg, but I know it's cool and all, but I don't know, I'm just not a fan of bootlegs. I don't know if you can tell, like, the mouth is painted red. I don't know. I think you can there. Didn't come with a tag, sadly, but maybe I can find one on the internet, maybe somehow, and then, I see where the tag would have went, right there, so, and I also just ordered a few, like a pack of 100, like, tags, like, the plastic tags with the loops, and, there's a video actually made by Richie, so, the retag your figure, so, I'm gonna test it out and see if it hopefully works, and maybe if I ever find a tag for this guy, we'll definitely tag this guy. So let me know if there's some way you can just buy a tag. I don't know. But yep, the Showa Ghidorah. I got this from Rich Iso for like, I don't remember. The last vinyl, or whatever you want to say. Let me get it. Sorry, you probably already saw it a little bit. But it is the Bandai, I think 8-inch Bachelor Larva that came with this cool stand. It's kind of weird because it has the Mothra symbol as a stand. I think that would go with Mothra, not Bachelor, but I guess Bachelor's in the movie where they kind of, where the symbol is talked about. But this is a really cool figure. The paint on the back, and actually the stand is pretty on it. I'm not really going to play with it because I just don't want to. And but yes, the paint on the back, I really like. The wings are a hard plastic, and if you drop it, it'll probably break, and I'm not going to test that out. I also got this guy with the original box, and there are also these like little like things on each of the ends of the wings. I don't know what they really were, but I took them off. But got this guy off of Clawmark or Showcase Daikaiju, I don't remember, but one of those two. Almost forgot something, but this was sent to me from a good friend of mine that I've met, I believe my first year at G-Fest. Yes, my first year at G-Fest. Yeah, the first ever person I met at G-Fest. A guy named Sam. He's super duper cool, and he sent me a Treadmasters Godzilla, but it's a 6-inch. And it has blue spines, and it's actually in really great condition. There's not one chip of paint on this guy. That's kind of crazy, because how old? Like, 90s? And you rarely find these things not chipped. So, thank you, Sam, and I am enjoying them. Alright, now let's get into the good stuff. The really good stuff. Let me get it. The first thing I got was, or not the first, but one of the first thing I'm going to show, the good stuff, is the X Plus, not Plus, X Plus, Mechagodzilla 1993. They come with a box. They got it off of Amazon. I forget how much. Also comes with this little tail stand, because as you can see, you just tilt over, and I don't want that to happen. And he's also humongous. He easily takes the cake for the biggest X Plus I have. And he also has some good kind of movement, like shoulders, elbows, wrist, head, and the jaw. And I like to keep the jaw open because there is some amazing detail in this just figure in general. My first Mechagodzilla 93 figure too, so go big or go home. But yes, I love this figure. Yes, just Mechagodzilla. Alright, so the next thing I got, also with box, but I am too lazy to get it, is the X Plus Gigant 2004 Chainsaw version. Don't know what else you would call it. This guy also has a good amount of movement, a little arm movement, and these move. But yes, this guy is beautiful, and he's very spiky. Like, if I would chuck this at somebody, I would go to jail for murder. Don't take that as an idea. But the eyes, I don't know if you can tell, but like, they're kind of clear and stuff, and they have like little like dots and stuff. It's amazing. And like I said, he's very spiky, like, and like, it just hurts to hold this guy, so like, I'm trying my best not to hurt my hands when I'm holding on the tail like this. But yes, this thing is amazing. Got this off of Awesome Collector, and also thanks to Oh My Godzilla for pinning the link of this figure in his one of his YouTube videos. I think he got the standard hook arms, but yes, thank you for pinning the link of this guy, because I do not own a chainsaw guy into this moment. But yes, this guy's awesome. Alright, and the last thing I got, and my favorite X Plus, I also got for with box, I got the X Plus 30 centimeter Baragon. It comes with two heads. This head with the ears down and a lighter colored horn, and like a darker yellow horn that's more up and the ears up. I think, I'm not sure which one is which, but one's supposed to be 68, one's supposed to be 65. I think this is the 65 head, and this is the 68 head from Destroy All Monsters, and this one from Frankenstein versus Baragon. But yes, this is an amazing figure. My first Showa Baragon. There aren't too many good Showa Baragons out there. I guess there is the Bandai Premium, but like I said, go big or go home. Because the older Bandai with the green belly, I don't like it. And if I would want a green belly Baragon, I would just get a Marmot. If that's a thing, I don't know. But yes, a Baragon. And he came with box too, so got him off of Facebook's, I forget where or how or who. So that is everything I got. Yes, this is everything. Yeah. I might take a picture for the thumbnail of everything I got, but that is all I have to say. Hopefully, we could all be at G-Fest next year in person, not over computers, but nothing you can really do. So thank you guys for watching. See you guys in the next episode. Peace.
You're a monster.
I can swallow a bottle of alcohol in a feel like Godzilla. Better hit the deck like Zacardzilla. My whole squad's in here walking around the party, a cross between a zombie apocalypse and Bibbobby. Rain heenin', which is probably the same reason I